In the next 10 minutes, we're going to use Semrush to quickly identify some quality long-tail keywords that we can use for a respective niche. By the end of this video, you're going to be able to use this tactic for your niche as well to quickly identify some new opportunities for your site. Let's go ahead and dig right in. All right, so digging right in, the first thing you're going to want to do is navigate to Semrush. If you don't already have a Semrush account, you can sign up for a 30-day free trial using my link in the video description. That is more than 2 times the length of the standard trial, so you'll definitely get enough time to try everything out. But assuming you do have your Semrush account, the first thing you're going to want to do is you're going to want to go ahead and type in reddit.com. From here, this is going to give you all the respective keywords that Reddit ranks for organically. And what you're going to want to do next is you're going to want to set up an advanced search. So in order to do this, all you need to do is click organic search traffic here. And then what's going to happen is you're going to go into the organic research tab. This is where it's all about the filters. So what you want to do is you want to go ahead and set up a filter for word count greater than 3. Apply that, and then go ahead and also set your keyword difficulty to something that is less than 50. The reason why we're going to do this is because it's going to really give us a priority, a focus on looking at some long tail keywords that aren't potentially that hard to rank for. If you want to change this threshold, you totally can. If, for example, you're just starting out with your baby site, then what you might want to do is set your keyword difficulty to 30 or below. But the purpose here is that what we're going to do is we're going to look through Reddit to see exactly what Reddit might be ranking for in the top 1 to 5 spots on Google. The reason why we want to do this is because when we go ahead and set this sort of filter up, we are isolating for particular long tail keyword phrases that are ranking really well with Reddit pages. And the reason why that is a great keyword idea for you is because that means that it is likely very easy for you to outrank Reddit. Typically, when Google gives priority to a site like Reddit for long tail keywords like this, it means that there really isn't a well-structured blog page or article around this particular query. And that's why it gives preference to a particular aggregator site or content community like a Reddit or a Quora. And we're gonna be able to apply the same tactic with Reddit, with Quora a little bit later on if we need to. But from here, the last thing we really need to do is just go ahead and search our particular niche. I've made a couple of videos recently about the soccer niche, so let's go ahead and take a look at soccer. And then the other thing that I forgot to mention earlier is that you're going to want to also look at adding a condition and excluding the keyword of Reddit. The reason why is because this is going to exclude the keywords that are focused on things that people are specifically looking for on Reddit in this particular niche. When we've done that, you can see that there are 444 keywords that have a potential traffic of 3.3K just from this particular advanced filter. And what we can do from here is we can go ahead and start working our way through these particular keywords. So the best way to do this that I would recommend is to go ahead and click the export button and then go ahead and download it as a CSV. From here, you're going to get the option to open that CSV. And in this case, what I've done is I've gone ahead and opened up a new spreadsheet here. So what we're going to do is we're going to go ahead and import this all into a spreadsheet. To do this, all you need to do is go to File and then Import, and then from there, click Upload. From here, I drag my file, and then I'm going to be given the option to either create a new spreadsheet or replace the current spreadsheet. In this case, I'm going to go ahead and replace the current sheet. From here, you're going to get the import of all of the data from Semrush. And all you need to do from here is start to comb through these keywords and then flag out potential ideas. So right now, let's go ahead and take a look at what some of these keywords are. And then the first thing that I'm going to do is I'm going to go ahead and set up a data filter in order for me to parse through some of these a little bit more intently. One of the first things I'm going to do is I'm going to filter out for keywords that have at least 100 or more in keyword volume. So I'm going to go here, go to filter by condition, and then I'm going to do greater than 99. From here, this leaves me with 71 keywords. So I have still potentially a ton of great ideas in this mix. All I need to do here is I need to go ahead and either create a new column to the right or to the left of the respective long tail keyword. And then what I can do is I can just go ahead and mark for myself whether or not this is a good keyword. So I'm going to put in pursue into this respective column, but now all I need to do is just comb through these respective phrases. To do this, what I like to do is I actually like to sort it by alpha order just because it's easier to read through it. But in your respective example, you might want to keep things a little bit simpler and just keep it in the raw export. In this particular case, we can see our private soccer lessons worth it. That is definitely one I'd want to pursue. I'm going to mark an X there. Are there timeouts in soccer? Also going to mark that. Let's go ahead and see, can you use soccer cleats for lacrosse? I like that question. Do DC Urban Mom soccer? Not so much as in this particular case, because I don't really know what that is. Do Canadians call it soccer? I love that particular idea. Here you can see how much can soccer players squat? Love that as well. How to get a soccer ball in Fortnite Creative? Maybe. How to get into soccer? Sure. Is baseball harder than soccer? Of course, that sounds nice. And what I'm looking for as I go through these particular ideas is I'm looking for some long tail questions that people have. The reason why is because these are gonna be the people also ask phrases that people like to search for. So I'm just gonna go ahead and continue going through this. And what you can see is that there are a number of things that we can go through just to see whether or not this is something interesting to us. So I'm looking for things like, what does 3/4 mean in soccer betting? What does AFC stand for? What does real mean in soccer? What lights up a soccer stadium? So these are all some potential questions. Why do soccer players grab each other's crotch? Oh man. And then why do they water turf soccer fields? Okay. And so right here, what you can see is that just from this preliminary scroll through, I've identified 17 ideas. The reason why I say 17 is because it includes the top column when I select that. And so what I can then do is I can go ahead and either do an export from Quora where I repeat these methods, or what I can do is I can go ahead and look for greater than 50, but less than 100. So greater than or equal to 50, and or I'll do is between 50 and 100. So I'll do 49 and 100. All right, so in this case, I am looking for a couple more. So do football players wear soccer cleats? I like that, that's number 18. What is handicap draw in soccer? I like that, that's number 19. Average 2-minute mile for soccer players? That's an interesting question or statistic that people might look for. So that's number 20, I believe. I'm looking for 5 more, 4 more, 3 more. What do soccer players say? I like that one. 2 more. Do they sell jerseys at soccer games? Like that one as well. 1 more. How to lock your ankle in soccer. And there you go. So just like that, what I can do is I can go ahead and remove my filter, or I can go ahead and look at a filter view and then go ahead and just sort by the ones that are X's. And so there you have it. Just like that, what I've done is I've gone ahead and identified 25 ideas for my particular imaginary soccer niche site. And what you can see is that the search volume in total here is over 4,000 search. And so there's definitely a lot of potential here based off of just these keywords that I did a quick filter on. You can take this sort of approach with us all sorts of different websites, but the other one that comes to mind is Quora.com or even major forums for different niches. So in the case where you want to apply this method for yourself, go ahead and sign up for your 30-day free Semrush trial using the link in the video description below. And then let me know in the comments below how it goes using this technique. And in the case where you want even more Semrush tips, be sure to check out my video over here where I teach you a couple different things you can do with Semrush in under 15 minutes.